हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन टू द फाइल ऑपरेशन ऑन डेटा फाइल्स टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द fseek फंक्शन, ftl फंक्शन एंड rewind फंक्शन. बेसिकली दीज थ्री फंक्शन आर द पार्ट ऑफ द रैंडम एक्सेस फाइल प्रोसेसिंग ऑपरेशन. सी, सो दिस इज बेसिकली अवर टुडेज टास्क. And we will discuss about the fseek, ftl and rewind. But firstly, we will understand about what is the means of random access file processing system. Basically, we have the two type of file processing system in our computer system. First one is a sequential file processing and another one is the random access file processing system. So what is the means of sequential file processing system? The simple mean of the sequential file processing system, if you have a memory and if you want to allocate the data into this memory, then all the data will be allocated in sequentially manner. If I am talking about the random access file processing system, then suppose you have a memory and in this memory just like that, 1, then 10, then 3, then 6, then 5 means anywhere else. But these addresses are connected to each other. So how to perform the operation into random access file processing system? There are the three functions, fseek, ftl and rewind operation. These three functions are used to access the files, access the data, how to fetch the data, how to move the pointer from one space to another space, one byte to another byte, one byte to end of file bytes, beginning to ending, beginning to middle, what is the current position. So this is basically the sequential access file processing system. So now I am just going to the random access file processing system. Basically, as we know that in the random access file processing system, to perform such like of operation which is produced into the diagram. If I am going to explain the sequential access, that the so first means is the what is the means of access. Access means that you are just fetching the data from the record or a file. So if you have a file and every file have contains the number of bytes, and then you are fetching all the bytes in the sequential manner, a contiguous operation processes. Just like in the diagram, you are seeing that first byte, then you are going to the second byte, then you are going to the third byte, then you are going to the fourth, then fifth, then sixth, then seventh, then eighth. So this is the manner of the sequential access operations. Clear? Okay. Now I am just talking about the random access. In the random access, suppose we have such type of operation like that. We have a memory operation. So in this, one, then are going to 2, then are going to 3, then are going to 4, then 5, then 6, then 7 and then 8. So randomly your data are stored at anywhere into the memory or into your file. Or if you want to fetch your data as per this direction, in the first byte of the memory I will call the 1, then you are going to the fourth bit, then I will call to 2, then you are going to the second bit, then I will call to 3, just like that. Okay, so far we have used only sequential access in our programs. But for example, if I want to access the 44th record, okay, suppose I am here, okay, now I just want to access the 44th record from my files, then there are the two methods. The first one is the sequential method. You are going to byte by byte, but if you are going to the byte by byte operation, that is a very long process. You will get your record, 100% you will get your record, but it's a time consuming process. So what is my other option? The other option is my random access. We are just pass the 46th record. We will pass our 46 bytes and then we will directly approach to 47 or 48 or 49, whatever you want to access. Okay, so in the random access, data can be accessed and processed randomly. In this case, the 44th record can be accessed directly, with the use of the random access. There is no need to read each record sequentially. So if I want to access my 44th record, then no need to go byte by byte. With the random access, with the help of the random access file operating system, we will directly approach to our 44th record. How and how to perform this? For this operation, we will use fseek function. Fseek function is basically is find out the number of bytes which you have to call or which position you want the record, like 10th record, like 14th record, like 17th record, whatever you want to this. So for this purpose, in the fseek operation, you have the three types of argument. The first one is the file pointer. Second one is the how many bytes you want to displacement for forward direction, for backward direction. Means if where you want to go, in the positive manner or into the negative manner. If you are seeing in the positive, then that the simple mean is that you are skip the forward direction. And if you are working in the negative operation, there simply you are skip to the backward direction from the current position where you are. Suppose you are in the 26th record, then I am saying that two record back, then you are going to the negative direction. And if I am talking about the two record ahead, then you are going to the positive direction. So the second argument is the displacement, and the third one is the origin. Origin, where are you placed? In the beginning, in the current position means, and in the third one is the end of file. There are the three type of operation: beginning, current position, and end of file. Okay, so in the stdio.h file, you have the three type of constant. Already you have the three type of constant. First one is the seek underscore sect. Second one is the seek underscore current. And the third one is the seek underscore end. And there are the three type of operation. And the value for the set 0, 0 is denoted to the beginning of the file. 1 is denoted to the current position. And the third one is the seek end, the end of file. And the value is 2. Now there are some example to use the fseek functions. Like that, in the first example, a very simple example, fseek p is the file pointer, 10l. What is the means of this 10l? And the last one is the origin is 0. So what is the means of 0? I have already told you the means of 0 is beginning of a file. Okay, so here if I am working on this statement fseek p 10l and 0, what is the means? The origin is 0, that means the pointer is at the beginning of the file in the 0th byte. Simple. Second one, this is the displacement. How many bytes you will displace from your current position? Simple. So position pointer skip 10 bytes, but it is a positive, the plus, then you will skip 10 bytes forward from the beginning of the file. Since the second argument is a long integer, this is the long integer and L is attached with it. Because the second argument is long integer, then the L is denoted with the L, with the T, with the 10. Okay. Now I'm just going to second example, P5L1. What is the 1? 1 is the current position and 5 forward direction. Now I'm talking about the third one, seek set. Seek set is the beginning of a file, 0th position, 8 byte forward from the beginning of the file. If I'm talking about the fseek P5-5L, that is a negative, that means you are moving into the backward direction from the current position. From the current position 1. Okay. In this example, 0th L, 2, 2 means end of file. What is the means of 0th L? Nothing to, 0th byte. If you have 1, 2, 3, then you are going to forward and backward, but you have the 0th. Then you will not go to और यू विल नॉट स्किप टू एनी अदर, यू जस्ट स्टॉप इन टू एंड ऑफ फाइल। ओके, एफ सी पी माइनस सिक्स सी कैन एंड ऑफ फाइल एंड माइनस सिक्स एल द मीन्स ऑफ दिस यू आर बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन फ्रॉम द एंड ऑफ फाइल। ओके, सो दिस इज द सम बेसिक एग्जाम्पल टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट दीज थिंग्स। नाउ आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू एक्सप्लेन वन थिंग, now in this example you have a file and in this file you have a six record and the every record needs a 4 bytes. This is the record number, record 1, record 2, record 3, record 4, record 5 and record 6. And what have I have a number of bytes, this is the number of bytes. The first record will contain 4 bytes, then 4 to 7, then 8 to 12, 11, the number of bytes. Or you can say, now this is the address, these are the address starting from 2000 and the first record will be end in the 2003, the second record is stored in the 2004 and then go ahead like that. Okay, so what is the purpose of this example? The simple purpose of this example is to explain how to perform the FSEEK operation. If you want to access, now I just want to write here, 1 minute. Now, fseek 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 function have, what is the one? First one is the file pointer. So, you have the fp your file pointer. Now, second, I just want to find out the third record. I just want to find out the third record. 1 minute. Third record. So, what is the means of third record? Where is the third record? From where you have to see? This is the record first, second, and third, and where from start? 2008. And what is the byte? 8. Okay? So how to calculate and how to reach into record 3? See, simple, n minus 1, what is the means of n minus 1? The simple n minus 1 is that the number of record, the value of 3 is equal to n equal to 3, the value of this one, like that. Okay, n equal to 3. Now how to get this value, how to set this value for fseek function? Okay, how many bytes you have taken? The 4 bytes, n minus 4. The simple thing here, we have to multiply by 4 because of one record will contain the 4 bytes. Okay, comma, from where? 0 position. Where you have to start? From 0 position. Okay, so now what is the means of this fseek? In the fseek fp comma, what is the value of n? The value of n is 3 minus 1 and multiply by 4. Okay, comma, from where start? 0. So what is the value fseek bracket fp comma, 3 minus 1 means 2 and 2 multiply by 4 means 8 and then 0. So this is basically the calculation of fc function. So from beginning 0 and where you have to start the searching operation, 8 byte, this is my 8 byte, and we will find out the record number 3rd. So this is the basically option of the fc function. From beginning, how to calculate the value and how to calculate the record for the operation purpose. Okay, now go ahead. This is the program basically. Firstly, we will understand about the nomenclature for this program, and then we will understand about the output for this program, and we will move ahead. In this program, we have a record. And in this record, we have a Record, what is record? Record is a structure. And in this structure, we have the three types of data: character data, integer data, and a float data. And a character data have how many bytes? 201 bytes will be occupied. Roll number contains only 2 bytes. Floats contains only 4 bytes. So, one record will have contain 201 plus 2 plus 4. Means 207 bytes will be occupied for one record. Okay. So, I have created a pointer, FP pointer, and pointer is basically contain the address of another variable. We know very well. So, what is the purpose of this pointer? This FP will contain the address of the file, where the file is stored. And when you are open this file, then this FP will point out this file. Understand about this statement. See, FP equal to F open stu dot dat. Okay. stu.dat. So what is the working here? FP will point out stu.dat in which mode? Read binary mode, because DAT and we will working on the read binary mode. Now if FP will get the addresses, get the value, then it will not be null and the else part will be executed. Otherwise, if you get the value, If you get the null, the null equal to null, and you will error in file opening because this file is not present here, which location you have produced this, and from this exit you will come out from the program. So if you get the file, your FP will point out the file. Then simply this is the process where we can read the data and produce in front of you, like roll number, name, marks, fread. With the use of the fread function, we have already understood in the my previous section, fread, address student, size of students, one record per operation, then fp equal to one, then the value will be come here. Okay, so now this is the important one which we will have to understand very clearly for the fc operation. Enter the file number to be read. Which record you want to read? Like suppose I just want to say I want to read a third record. Okay. So in this section, the value of n equal to 3, 3 minus 1 equal to 2, and size of student 207. Then 2 multiply by 207. So what is the means of this? 207. Yani ki how much bytes? 2 into 207. 414. Okay, 414 bytes from the beginning. You are moving from the beginning 414 bytes, and you will get your second record or third record, whatever you have to enter. Okay, so here again, with the use of the read function, I will read the current pointer. After the displacement, with the use of the read function, we will fetch out the number of 207 byte. We will get from the, with the help of the fread function. And here we are just showing that. Now see this. So in this we have the number, roll number, Rohan, and marks 90. Okay. This is the basically our record. And enter the record number to be read. Okay. I want to say that second record. Okay. Second record is 3, Amit, and 80. And this is my second record in front of you. Okay, so I hope so is it clear how to work of the fseek function. Now the next one is the ftel function. What is the work of the ftel function? Ftel will always return a current position of the file pointer. Where is the present position of the file pointer in the file system which you are using? Okay, the whole the program as it save, where you have to use the read the file. With the help of the fseek function, we will find out the file, find out the record, and then we are using ftel. एफ टेल पोजिशन पॉइंटर इन द बिगिनिंग. आफ्टर द सीकिंग द रिकॉर्ड वट इज द योर करेंट पोजिशन, हाउ मैनी बाइट्स आफ्टर हाउ मैनी बाइट्स यू आर वर्किंग. तो एफ टेल पॉइंटर विल पॉइंट आउट ऑन दैट करेंट पोजिशन की प्रेजेंट वर्किंग वेयर. देन यू आर रीडिंग द नेक्स्ट रिकॉर्ड आफ्टर दैट एंड एंड एवरी लूप वी विल गेट द पोजिशन पॉइंटर एफ टेल एफ पी. ओके नाउ सी वी हैव 2, 3, 4, 5. ओके एंटर द रिकॉर्ड नंबर टू बी रीड. आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू रीड द थर्ड रिकॉर्ड. ओके नाउ आफ्टर द थर्ड रिकॉर्ड यू विल गेट द 4, 7, and 79. दिस इज योर पोजिशन पॉइंटर इन द बिगनिंग 6, 3, 6. From the beginning, you are moving 636 bytes. You are moving on 636 bytes. And now, the this one position pointer after the first loop, you are read your data by end of the file. This is basically the operation for the FTEL function. Okay. Now after that, we will understand about the rewind. What is the means of rewind? When you open a file and you want to update your record and whatever you are doing anything else, then if you are working on the current position and if you are going to the beginning of the file and if, okay, at that time you will use the rewind operation. This function is used to move the file position pointer to the beginning of the file. I just want to go to the previous position. Not the previous position, you just want to go at the beginning. Then you will use the rewind function. Okay, so how to this use? Suppose I have pointer, I have open file, I have used the FC function, and you are going to the end of file. Okay, and after that I have used the FTEL and go get the number where is the which is the your current position, which is your current byte operation, and then you will get perform the rewind function. And in this rewind function, after this rewind function, again I have checked that what is the current position, and the output is like that. Position pointer is 0. After the seeking function means you are moving into the end of file and present position 8, 40 to 8, 48. And after the rewind function, again you are in which position? On the current file position. Okay, so this is basically the rewind function. If you want to go to the beginning of the file, and the time you will use the rewind. And after that, the next one, this is the wrong one, this is not a rewind, this is the end of file. Okay, so in the end of file operation, in the end of file, we will discuss another way, on the another way. The first one, you are using basically the looping operation, you are using the return statement to return a null value, and a lot of operation with the help of you can check your file data and you are at the end of file. But a function which is provided by the file handling operation is the FEOF. With the use of the FEOF, we will find out that what is our current position. My current position is end of file or another thing. If you are the position in the end of file, it returns a non-zero value. If end of file has been reached, otherwise it returns 0. If you are end of file condition, it returns always a non-zero value like 1. Okay, and apart from this, if you are not in this, if you are not end the reach file, it will always return as 0. Okay, so what is the help? If you are using the reader file, at that operation, f read ampersand student size of the student 1 and fp. Okay, while f end of file fp. First time you have read the data, then second, then third, then fourth, then five, then six. Now you are at the position of end of file. At that time, here the value is 1. And if this, what is the means of? This is a negation. Then what is the value? 1 equal to, and the negation value will convert the 1 into in the fall position like 0. And the loop will be break here. And if you are working to like that, if you are reading the data like that, the first one is the your code to read the file. You have firstly read the file, then you are going to outside, and this is the another way you have to perform. If you are working on the F end of file, then you firstly read, then print, then read, then print, then read, then print. Okay. In the last recall of the program may be processed twice, since in the C end of file is indicated only after an input function has made an attempt to read at the end of file. So this is basically the end of file operations. Okay, and thank you to listening me, and my phone number is 8449687767. If you have any query, then you can call me. Okay, and my email ID dpn.rastogi@galgotiasuniversity.edu.in. If you have any query, then you can mail me. Thank you. Thank you very much.